Check it out! From the last episode, we cool down our gun to 0 degrees Celsius and zero shot. This is how lots of GBB guns behave in the cold temperature. It's kind of like common sense for decades. Like, we all know that airsoft guns perform really bad during cold weather. But why is that though? Why has the temperature has to do with the pressure? And what actually happens to the gun? And also, what is the easiest way possible to improve your gas gun's performance during cold weather? In this episode, we are going to go over all that. This is the quad gas container. Based on the last video that we showed you guys exactly what happens inside the gas gun's magazine when it's being fired, and a lot of you guys were asking how the pressure related to the temperature. So if you haven't seen our last video, make sure you click the link on the left so you get a better idea of what's going on right now. Now, let's take a look at the container. The current temperature inside is 24.1 or 2, and the pressure inside is 10 kilograms per centimeter squared. But first, to understand the cost of those two phenomena, we are gonna set this exact same setup into the two extreme temperatures that we test out from last time, which was 0 degrees Celsius and 50 degrees Celsius. And during this time, we're gonna observe how the pressure changes under those two temperatures. On the other hand, some people suggest that we should do the FPS measurement and fire with BBs to see the impact on different temperatures. So we got curious and we want to know how we can further study this cold GBB sucks phenomenon. And we found this video. It's called Schlieren Imaging. That's the technique to turn invisible flows into something visible, which allows us to see all the tiny differences in air, either temperature, pressure, and compression. And yes, we are gonna film a GBB pistol with it and observe how gas behaves during different temperatures, and we will add on the FPS this time.
Here comes the Schlieren Master. But yeah, this thing took us almost 2 hours to set up, but finally we got the camera set up, the lightings, the blades, and the magical mirrors.
This is a technique called Schlieren effect. And let me ask you guys a question. When's the last time you see air in your life, right?
Here, let me do a very quick demo. I'm gonna tape a balloon right here. Take a blade, and Brendan, get the camera ready, please. All right, here's the blade. Fire it in 3, 2, 1. You don't see anything, right? But let's check it out on this side. Zoom in.
It's like Mickey Mouse.
Okay, quick.
Oof.
So yeah, this is actually
what happened. And this is called the Schlieren effect. If you guys want to know how to set it up exactly, knowing all the details about it, make sure to check out this guy's channel. We got the link right below. You can find out the details yourself. For the pistol that we're testing today, it is something very special to me. This is the ICS Court PRS. This one is the silver one. Apparently this is the sample gun I borrowed from them. It performs really well. And sorry, this one is not really available. It's kind of the one and only. Hopefully, this filming technique could help us to observe how GBB guns behaves while they're firing, which is something that we can't observe at the regular circumstances. Also, we filled our PRS with 12 kg gas and 0.2 gram BBs, and we measured the muzzle velocity in normal temperature, which was 25.3 degrees Celsius. The average velocity of the first 10 shots were 85.7 meters per second. Then we did the same process and reset the gun into both hot and cold chambers as well. Back to the gas container, let's take a look at the current temperature. Now it says it is 0.7, actually minus, so we're really close to the temperature. Now let's take it out and set it up real quick. Fresh. So set it up. Don't want the temperature to go off. All right, we're all set. Now let's take a look at the pressure right now. The pressure is really, really low at the moment, which is 4 kilograms per centimeter square. This is really, really low, which is nearly 60% off the original gas pressure. Now, I'm gonna use the same old tool to hit the gas releasing valve that simulates a gun is firing at this kind of cold temperature. Let's see what happens inside the container. Brendan, ready?
Ready.
All right, fire then. 3, 2, 1, go.
From the slow motion, under the low temperature, you can see when the hammer hits the releasing valve, there's not enough pressure to push back the hammer, and closing the valve, that leads to a bulk of gas spurt out of the container. That is why sometimes the white vapor spurt out of the gun during the cold temperature.
Alright, it's been a while. Let's check out the gun's temperature. Hopefully it's ready. It's been there for a long time. Alright, the temperature is about right. Let's grab the gun. It's super cold. Get the gun loaded. Ready, ready?
Ready.
Okay. Fire it in 3, 2, 1, go. 3, 2, 1, go. The gun is probably not gonna work, but...
We've never seen something like this before, and to be honest, I didn't know this much of gas came out from the rear of the slide.
Okay, apparently it's not working at 0 degrees.
And the average FPS in cold temperature test shows
62, 62, and 166. That's... No, definitely not the average. The 166, that must be the gas. This thing right here, this is the safety box because we are gonna heat this thing up to 50 degrees Celsius and I'm not perfectly sure if this is gonna blow up in my face. So for safety's sake, we really need this thing to protect our face. Okay? Now we got a heater and we're gonna turn it on and see what happens. F*** you! What the f***? Yeah, dude, like, it was just right on time. Like, Brendan and I, we were just looking at this thing close and it just fucking blew up. Make sure you never do this at home. I didn't even put the helmet on and this entire thing just blew up. Yeah, the container is done. I mean, it's probably gonna take some time to, like, really get it fixed. Even the screw is bented. And the pressure meter, I'm not sure if it still works, but, like, does it work? Alright, now based on what happened last time, I'm all scared, so safety first.
I think the temperature is about right. It's 53. Actually, I think the temperature is really high. Let's check it again. Ooh. Yeah, it's way high. I'm gonna turn it off and see if this gun still works.
Is the gun loaded?
Okay, Brendan, ready?
Ready.
Fired in 3, 2, 1, go. 3, 2, 1, go.
Okay.
This time, the releasing gas looked more focused in each shot.
Okay, that's it. Wow, still works.
In hot temperature test,
61.
The muzzle velocity shows.
Hot. Test the gun out.
And the average MPS is 93.4 meters per second, which is a lot higher than the normal temperature. From the slow motion, you can see in high temperature, the speed of the muzzle gas is much faster, which has the better concentrated force to push the BBs. And in cold temperature, because of the low pressure, the gun cannot have an effective actuation. which makes the gun spray out much more useless gas from everywhere. And the muzzle velocity shows the pistol in 0 degrees Celsius is completely dead. In 50 plus degrees Celsius, the speed increased quite a bit, but it's not consistent because of the light striking issues caused by the high pressure. And in 25 plus degrees Celsius, the gun has a stable performance.
If you want to make your gun's performance better during cold weathers, well, you can use the higher pressure gas like the 14 kgs and the 16 kgs out there in the market. Use heat packs. I've seen Japanese players put those heat packs into their mag pouches. That keeps the magazine at a certain temperature, or the fancier one, you can use electric pouches.
So what is your method to improve your GBB gun's performance during cold weather? Leave it down in the section below and let us know your thoughts.
Hey Andrew, see?
Yeah?
The gun doesn't fit.
Wait, what?
Well, I see. Well, let's build a chamber.
Demons call when they do what they do. And now I feel like taking off, find a place with a view. The pain is never gonna stop if it's controlling you. I know the time can heal it all, I just gotta get through. I just gotta get through, I just gotta get through. Cause I feel like taking off, find a place with a view. The pain is never gonna stop if it's controlling you. I know the time can heal it all, I just gotta get through. Sometimes I feel like all is lost, but I know it's not true. I wanna put up all my walls cause I'm not in the mood. But then I cut myself off from the rest of the room. I know that time can heal it all if you're patient, and soon it can all be worth it, all the searching. Pain is never really permanent, but damn it hurts, man. I could feel all of the turbulence and it's concerning. I've been searching for a purpose, I hope it's worth it. This society is really trying me. Ain't no hide and seek, I hide to be far from anxiety.
Hey guys, sorry for taking so long, but here's the reason why. The quad temperature testing chamber. The panel on the top, this space, it fits our freezer, in which it really allows us to cool down the entire chamber down to 0 degrees Celsius. Here we got the heating panel, in which we can also heat up this chamber up to 50 degrees Celsius. And last but not the least, this is the BB catcher, because we want to test out the gun inside different temperatures. And this catcher will catch the BBs, and the chrono allows us to get the number. But like, why bother building this? Because we love science, especially when it's airsoft related. This chamber will become our golden standard that gives different kinds of airsoft guns the same testing environment. So how do we define the gas efficiency test though? We will set the chamber temperature to 10 degrees Celsius and fire the gun until the slide can no longer travel fully or lock to the rear. We call the malfunction and stop counting. Then we will calculate the effective shots fired and divide that by the magazine capacity. For instance, a magazine can hold 20 rounds and fire 12 effective shots inside the chamber. This means the gun's gas efficiency can only supply 0.6 magazines and will get 5 points. The grading system is ready and the chamber is finally ready. And there are so many guns out there in the market. Now, let's test some guns.